Because in our poverty, in our hell, I'm going to come and deliver the broken, destroyed, messed up, poor, impoverished people. I'm going to deliver.
Shalom Israel, Yahweh Bashim Yav Shad Raka Thug, Yahweh Shema Ala Thug Bashim Yav Shad, all the sisters, man. Listen, it's Captain 13,000, the card of a rhyme, checking in with the Israelite School of UPK under Commander Jerry Hunt. Listen, man, this year's 52nd annual Passover. Hold on, I'm gonna say it one more time. This year's 52nd annual Passover under Commander Jerry Hunt under the ISUPK. Couldn't do it last year. Y'all already know the Lord had his foot on our oppressor's neck.
Here in New York City, there are roughly 1,000 cases a day. Those are numbers they haven't seen since May.
Can't do it in New York this year because the Lord still got his foot on our oppressor's neck.
New York, the center of the outbreak this spring, is now teetering on another deadly explosion of the virus.
But listen to me good. This year, 52nd annual Passover, April 24th, 2021. You understand? It's going to be in H-Town, baby.
It's going to be at the B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Y'all know what we do. Y'all know what we came to do. Huh? 2021, ISUPK, 52nd annual Passover. All the generals gonna be there. All the heavy hitters gonna be there. The daughters of Zion gonna step out with their beautiful long dresses, you understand? Strong on deck. That One West style music on deck. 52nd annual Passover.
B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Get with it to get lost, man.
Got it out the mud, straight up out the base. The world done made me crazy. The world done turned crazy.
You dealing with the men of war. We at war. I sided with the Lord, of course. On one accord. We ain't never stopping now. You running now. All my niggas go to ground.
2021 is not even a new year. I'm gonna show you how the white man's such a liar. He changes the times. Do you even know the new year doesn't start in the dead of winter? Drop that. Let's get that. I'm going to show you just how much of a devil the white man is. While we out here trying to follow their culture, I'm going to show you how just how stupid their culture is. This is how backwards it is. You understand? The white man says the new year's is January 1st. I'm going to show you the Bible says something different. And I'll prove it to you. Where you at with it? Give me Salaki. Give me Romans 12 and 2. I'm going to show you how the white man is so sneaky, he changed the times. Imagine how arrogant you got to be to say, yeah, I'm going to change the times. You know why we have daylight saving time? Anybody know why we have that? Daylight saving time was instituted because when Julius Caesar implemented the new calendar, the days did not line up with the sunlight. Meaning after a while, it could have been 12 o'clock in the afternoon, but the sun wasn't reflecting that. So they created daylight savings time to compensate for the sunlight to match the time. That's why it happens every year. In October, we lose an hour. In October, we gain an hour. In March, we lose an hour, right? I'm gonna show you how the white man, the Bible talks about he would do this. Read that.
The book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2. And it be not conformed to this world, but ye transformed.
Give me Exodus 12. The Bible right there, 12 and 1, the water cap. The Bible is saying, do not be conformed to this world, man. This is what I just was talking about. Just because we live in America doesn't mean we have to do what they do. The Chinese man lives in America and he does not do what the white man does. He don't know, he didn't come and learn how to learn English the proper way. Chicken wing, fried rice, you know what I'm saying? Meanwhile, they tell us, speak proper. You sound so ghetto and ignorant. But the Chinese man walking around here, that's why I check on. Are you ready for order? What are you saying? Speak proper English, damn it. We had to learn it. Ain't that right? Don't they tell us that? But it shows you the double standard. The white man wants black people to be servants to American culture. You understand? Because the white man understands the moment we disassociate ourselves from American culture is when we'll start to prosper. The same way the Chinese prosper.
Right.
The Chinese people come over here and don't associate themselves with the white man, and there's Chinatowns in every major city in the U.S. Do we got Niggertown anywhere? Where's Niggertown? I want to know. Where's it at?
That's right.
Cause I want to know. I'm going to be the first one moving there. You show me Niggertown, I'm getting a house. I want to be the mayor, right? Right. You understand? I'm going to show you right here. The Bible is going to tell us when the year actually starts. Read that.
The book of Exodus chapter 12 verse 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, saying, this month shall be unto you.
Now, stop. Let me give you a little backdrop real quick. Everybody's familiar with Moses, right? Moses is famous for leading the children of Israel, our people, out of slavery in Egypt. If you didn't understand, those slaves in Egypt were black people, just like us. Where that sign at? Where the slave? Check out this sign right here, man. You understand? Y'all look at this right here. The same slavery we served in America is the same way we served in Egypt. That's why America idolizes Egypt. You understand? Read from the top.
12 and 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, saying, this month shall be unto you the beginning of
months. The what?
Beginning.
The what?
Beginning of months.
Now the Lord is speaking to Aaron and Moses. When Moses brought us out of Egypt, the Lord expected for us to establish our own nation. That's why he took us out of Egypt, because we were slaves in Egypt. When you're a slave, you can't practice your own culture and religion. You know, what happened to black people when we got here as slaves? They made us learn English. They made us serve white Jesus. We couldn't practice our original culture. So that's why the Lord brought us out of Egypt, so that we can establish our own nation. And as we're establishing our own nation, the Lord is telling us, this month right here is going to be the beginning of months. What do you call the beginning of months? The new year, right? That's what it is. If it's the beginning of the months, it's the new year. Right now, we think the new year is January 1st. So you will say January is the beginning of months. Is that not true? January, February, March, April, May. Well, guess what? I'm going to show you right here what is the actual beginning of months according to the scriptures. Read.
Speak ye unto all the congregation of Israel, saying, in the tenth day of this month, they shall take them to every man a lamb according to the house of their father, a lamb for an house. And if the household be too little for the lamb, let him and his neighbors next to his house take it according to the number of the soul.
What we read about right here is what the Bible calls the Passover. The Passover is when the Lord killed every firstborn Egyptian because they refused to let our people go out of slavery. So in order to get the Egyptians to let us go, the Lord killed every firstborn Egyptian. And that's when they decided, we got to get these people out of here. Well, we celebrate that holiday to this day. It's called the Passover. The new year starts in the Passover. And I'll show it to you. I'll prove it to you. Where we at? Give me Exodus 16 and 1. I'm going to show you right here. The new year is not in January. What is new in January? You look around, there's no life on the trees. When something is new, what does that mean? It's fresh. When a baby is born, when you have a newborn baby, the baby is not born losing hair. The baby is not born old and wrinkled and gray. The baby is born strong and fresh and growing. So how is the winter is the new year? You would think, well, wouldn't the new year be in a time period when everything starts to grow again and be fresh? I'll prove it to you. I'll show you. No sweat. Read.
The book of Exodus, chapter 16, verse 1. And they took their journey from Elam, and all the congregation of the children of Israel came into the wilderness of Sin, which is between Elam and Sinai, on the 15th day.
16 and 1. No sweat. Keep reading. Give me 15 and 1. I'm going to show you right here. The Bible talks about the beginning of months. It talks about it, and it's important that we understand this because it's in our culture. Our culture is not to follow the white man in New Year's. It's not even a new year. The year's not over yet. 2020 is not over. 2020 got two more months, three more months until it's over. You understand? Read.
Exodus chapter 15, verse 1. Then sang Moses and the children of Israel this song unto the Lord and spake, saying, I will sing unto the Lord, for he hath drunk gloriously. The horse and his riders have he thrown into the sea.
This is a song we used to sing to celebrate our real New Year. We celebrated the death of our enemies. And this is another scripture for you Christians that think God is all love and hugs and kisses. That's not who we ever were as a people, and that's not our God, man. We are a people that look to see our haters fail, man. It's not hard to believe. Don't you wish to see your haters not prosper? That's black people, man. That's us. The problem is we think our fellow people is the haters, but that's not the case. Our haters are the ones who seek to destroy our race. That's the white man today, and it was the Egyptians back then. And we celebrated God killing the Egyptians and delivering us out of Egypt, man. Now read this. I'm going to show you how you know the Bible tells you when the month starts, when the new year starts.
Nisan, month. Nisan is the Hebrew and Babylonian calendars. Is this the month of the barley reaping and first month?
Read a little bit slow so you understand. Go ahead.
It's the month of the barley ripening, and the first month of spring.
This right here in the Bible, the word, the month that's beginning of the year is called Abib. Okay, that's the white man's Yiddish. It translates into Nisan, and once again, white man's Yiddish. But it's telling you that this month that's supposed to be the beginning of the year is when everything starts to ripen, to be born again. Can somebody tell me what season does everything start to come back alive? Does the vegetation, the grass, the plants come alive? Say it again. Spring, that's common sense. You see how they knew that? Get in my hand, man, for having courage to tell the truth. Spring, man. Spring is when everything comes to life. That's why they call it spring, because life springs forth out of the plants. The buds start to open up. The bears that went to sleep in the wintertime that hibernated, they come out of their hibernation in the spring. Everything comes to life in the spring. That's why we get them allergies, because the new plants produce so much pollen, it's messing up everybody's sinuses. The spring is the month when the year begins. It only makes sense. How is something the new year if you're not letting it be new? January is still the wintertime, right? So what's new about January? What's new? Look at that tree right there. Look at the tree, the water said, look at the tree. Ain't no leaves on it, that tree is dead. There's no life on the tree. But come springtime, the tree is gonna be new again. Leaves are gonna be on it. You see how the Bible's practical knowledge? It's not spooky, heebie-jeebie Christianity. The Bible is practical knowledge. And the Bible's saying our new year begins in the Passover. And the Passover is held in this month right here, which is in spring. The new year was not January 1st, 2020. I hate to break it to you. Y'all was celebrating the end of 2020. There's three. Right, wasting all the goddamn ammo. Y'all was just crying. It's a shortage in bullets. But I got a suffering here. Sound like Afghanistan in my neighborhood. Everybody busting off outside. Good night. I was jealous too. I was like, good night, boy. That sounds like some good ammo that's going to waste. Well, guess what? 2020 is not over yet. There's three more months left. The new year begins in the spring. And you know why you should care about that? Because now you realize that if the new year is not now, then when was I celebrating? When was I out there partying and sleeping with whores and getting high and doing all type of freakisms and nastiness? What was I doing all that for? If the white man lied about the new year, what else did he lie about? You got to ask yourself that. Look at that right there. If he lied about the new year, of course he's going to lie about our King, Christ. Of course he's going to lie about who we are as a people. Of course he's going to lie about our language and our customs. If you went out and partied on January 1st, you were worshiping a God that's not of this Bible. You were worshiping a pagan God, and you don't understand that. You ever hear somebody say, I got a New Year's resolution? You know what that comes from? The New Year's resolution is from, in history, White men used to settle all their debts. They used to resolve all their debts that they owed on the new year so they can go into the new year debt free. Well, guess what? Black people, we took that and now we say, well, my New Year's resolution is this. Well, that's not what that means, man. Do you know, if you go look at your phone right now, there's a day called Heartbreak Day. Look up Heartbreak Day when you get a chance. Heartbreak Day is when we were in slavery. Guess what? We used to wait for New Year's to pass because the next day, that meant that our families were going to get separated. You know why? Because on the New Year's, white men resolved their debts. So us being in slavery, us being the property and the commerce, if a white man had to sell your daughter to settle his debt, then so be it. That's why if you look on your phone right now, Heartbreak Day, or they call it Hiring Day, because slaves were hired and sold to different plantations on New Year's Day. So while we out here partying and getting lit and thinking we enjoying ourselves, we really commemorating so much garbage. Not only are we worshiping a false god, we commemorating the day where our families were split apart in slavery. The white man sold our kids and our wives and our fathers like property, like money, just so they can be debt free. That's what we celebrating, man, in America. And that's why God is going to destroy America. You understand? Start read that in 1508, Bob Gashot. Check this out right here. See, brothers back here, we don't just get up here and God's got a blessing. Get ready. We don't do that back here. These brothers are hardcore soldiers that actually love black people enough to do the goddamn research. We actually go in the books. We actually go look up the dates. We actually go and study. You know why? Because contrary to popular belief, black people were smart. Black people were smart as hell, man. And brothers, we are trying to prove to the world that our people don't have to be what the white man tells us to be. We're not just thugs and criminals and whores. We are scholars and prophets back here, man. And because of that, we're going to read some information. Read this.
In 1508, French poet Aloy Adverill referred a position d'Avril, April Fool, literally April's fish, possibly the first reference.
Go ahead, sir. So what we're going to bring out is in England, they used to celebrate New Year's Eve in March and in April. But when Julian changed the calendar, they start calling people fools because the white man changed the times and made a new year in January. They made a new year in January. They used to celebrate New Year's in March and in April because that's when everything, it was spring, everything was new. Go ahead and read. It's like April's fish. And this is 1508, the year 1508. Go ahead.
Possibly the first reference to the celebration in France. Some writers suggest that April Fool's originated because in the Middle Ages, New Year's Day was celebrated on March 25th.
You hear that? In the Middle Ages, New Year's was celebrated in March 25th.
Right.
In the Middle Ages. Go ahead.
In most European towns, with a holiday that in some areas of France, especially ended on April 1st.
Right, man. So a lot of the New Year's, for them, a lot of the New Year started March 25th and then April 1st. This is back in 1508. And before that, the world will recognize the New Year as in spring. Go ahead and read.
And those who celebrated New Year's Eve on January 1st made fun of those who celebrated on other dates.
You hear that? So now when the time was changed, people that kept the old New Year's, they would make fun of them. So now the people who kept the new year on January 1st will make fun of you if you kept the old tradition and recognized New Year's in the springtime in March and April.
Right.
It's because of the white man is evil and he's changed times, man.
Right.
He thinks
right.
He is God.
Right.
That's why the Lord has destroyed him. He is a lion. Just like he, that's it. Just like the brother, and that's where April Fool's come from.
Right.
When we was kids, we said, and think about it. We do a lot of things in America, we don't even know why we do it. As a kid, why do we celebrate April Fool's? Why? Like, I remember I was trying to April Fool's my mother, my teacher, and other kids, but we didn't even know why we were celebrating April Fool's. It was all about people mocking other people, keeping the real New Year, which was in the springtime. That's just a little knowledge. Look, we universal. We a universal practical knowledge, man.
Right.
We got knowledge. We have universal knowledge back here. Come and grab you some flyers, man. This brother will keep on teaching, but we got online classes, man.
That's right.
This is the only place. We have classes in D.C. Come and sit in these classes and learn the knowledge. You'll have knowledge, man, and you'll stop being lied to. Go ahead.
That's right.
Like,
now get that power, preach the power of the hand, man. What he said was so true. You probably didn't even know April Fool's Day came from that. It came from them changing the times. And I'm gonna blow your mind even further. Did you know the Bible says that the white man would change the times? You probably didn't even know that. Did you know before we had 12 months, we used to have 10 months? You ever notice that? Anybody know what does octopus mean? How many legs does an octopus have? Eight tentacles. Because the word oct is the prefix meaning eight. So let's check this out. Let's break something down real quick. October, it should be the eighth month. September should be the ninth month, because nine is the prefix. Sept is the prefix for nine. Sept. Yeah, the water. Sept is the prefix for seven. December is the prefix for 10. You understand? That's why you have a decimal. It's referring to a 10 spot. It's referring to 10. Why is it now that October is supposed to be the eighth month, but it's the 10th month? And September is supposed to be the seventh month, but it's the ninth month. And December is supposed to be the 10th month, but it's the 12th month. Because Julius Caesar added two extra months, January and February. January was added to honor their god Janus. Janus is a two-faced god in Roman culture that looks to the past and looks to the future. And this god is referring to new beginnings. That's why you celebrate New Year's in January. You understand? You see how the white man, how the hell are you gonna add two extra months to the time? The white man gonna add months to the time and add days. Like, who gave him the authority to do that? You understand? Like, that's just outlandish, but that's what they do. And the Bible said they would do that. I'm gonna prove it to you. Read, give me Daniel 7:25. I'm gonna prove to you the Bible is a real book, man. This Bible is not fairy tales. I know everybody likes to say, the white man wrote that book. That book was used to enslave us. That's lies, man.
That's right.
If the white man wrote this book, thank you, sister, why would he say in this book, he's the devil? Why would you call yourself the devil in your own book? Because the white man didn't write this book. The white man will never call himself the devil. You see how he portrayed himself in all these superhero movies? How the hell you got a Justice League and they all white?
Right.
How the hell you gonna have the Avengers and they all damn near white? That's why black people were so happy when we got Black Panther. Because we finally felt like we had one superhero. Because all of them is white. The white man always gonna portray himself as the hero. So if the, thank you, brother. So if the white man is not the hero in the Bible, then you would know he didn't write the Bible. In this book, the white man is the villain. He's the author of all mischief. That's in the scriptures too. I'm going to say the Bible said the white man was going to change the times. Read.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High.
Read that again.
And he shall speak great words against the Most High.
The Bible says the white man shall speak great words against the Most High.
Right.
What's some of those great words that the white man speaks against the Most High? We're the real Jews. The Christ is white. The black man could never be the real Jews. God loves everybody. When the Bible says God doesn't love everybody. I can show you a scripture right now where it says God hates a certain set of people. So how does God love everybody according to the white man? But the Bible says God hates one people and he loves another people. Right, so God loves Michael Brown and the cop that killed him. God loves Emmett Till and the white woman that lied on him. It don't work like that. Right. God loves the rapist and the woman that was raped. Right. That's a lie, man. That's a lie. And these are some of the things that the white man speaks against God. I'll give you another one. I brought it out earlier. The Bible says two men laying with each other is an abomination. The Bible says if you smoke, that's a sin. The Bible says pork is not to be consumed by our people. What does America say? Two men lying together is an alternative lifestyle. It's your choice. Love who you love. The white man says pepperoni and pork is the best meat. It's the other white meat. You understand? The white man speaks everything contrary to what God says. You know, because if the white man followed what God said, he wouldn't be in charge of us. He wouldn't be over us. You know why? Because God said that we are the special children above all people. But he takes it upon himself to do everything against God. And then have the nerve to put "in God we trust" on his dollar bill. That's why God is going to destroy America. Because that's who they trust, their money. Their money is their God. They don't respect the God of this Bible. And the Bible says that. He's going to speak great words against the Most High. Keep reading.
"And shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change the times and law."
Whoa, slow it down, Kadar, because they think we are making this up. They think we just up here pulling this out of a book that we didn't wrote. And this is the Bible. This is the actual Bible. The same Bible that's in the Christian church. The same Bible that Eddie Long should have been reading and following, but instead he was molesting boys. The same Bible that every pastor should be reading, but they stealing all your grandmama's 401k money and Social Security checks. This Bible is saying that the white man will change the time. Read it again from the top.
Daniel chapter 7, verse 25. "And he shall speak great word." Speak great words against the Most High, "and shall wear out the saints of the Most High."
And the Lord said the white man will wear out the saints of the Most High. Now with the blow Christians' minds once again. What is a saint according to the Bible? Anybody? It's okay to be wrong. For time's sake, a saint is an Israelite. That's who's referring to. I know you got Christian songs. Donnie McCormick had a song where a saint is just a sinner who fell down and all that gay garbage. That's not what a saint is. A saint is referring to a specific person, a black, Hispanic, or Native American. If you on this side, you are the saints of the Lord. That's what's referring to, man. And the scripture says the white man will wear out the saints of God. What does it mean to wear out the saints? If we go, remember when we was younger, your parents would be like, you act up, I'm gonna wear your tail out. What does that mean? That's what the white man is doing to our people. He's wearing our people out. That's why we get high. That's why we kill each other. That's why black women think they have to kill their own baby in abortion clinics. That's why black men rob other black men. Because our lives are so oppressive because the white man is wearing us out, man. He's absolutely wearing us out. Physically too. Why do you think, how many black people gotta work two or three jobs just to make it? If you're not working two or three jobs, you're working 16 hours on that one job you're working. Why do you think Uber was invented? And all these little DoorDash and Postmates, that wasn't for white people, that was for us, for side hustles. Because we need the extra income. Because we live in poverty. Because we live in hell. That's our lives. That's the reality of our life. And the white man did that on purpose. The white man knows if I can work them so hard, they won't be thinking about nothing else but coming and serving me and working. If I work them so hard, all they want to do is just get high to relieve themselves. It's strategic, man. Who the one that said we have to work 8 hours a day? Who established that? I don't even know that, do you? A white man. A white man established that. Who the one that said 8 hours a day is the standard of what hard work is? Who the one that said we should be, the business week should be 5 days? You see how that work? They establish what they want, and everything that they do is meant to destroy our people. They make us so tired that we don't have the energy to want to think about our culture in the Bible. They wear us out, so we don't want to think about we can't get high. All we're thinking about is, I just worked 16 hours. I want to go home and light this blunt up and enjoy myself because I worked hard enough. I thought I earned it. But we don't understand. God is saying, we can't do that. We have a culture that we have to follow. And that's why the white man wears us out the way he does, so that we can abandon our culture. Because if we follow our culture, he wouldn't be able to wear us out. He wouldn't be able to oppress black people. If black men today decided we are not going to kill each other no more, do you know how dangerous that is for a white man? If now we look at another black man and say, I wouldn't dare kill you no more. Now we got to look and say, well, if you're not the enemy no more, now we have to wake up and realize, well, we have an actual enemy, and it's not our fellow brother. And then we'll wake up and realize the white man was the one behind all of our suffering to begin with. The white man's the one that put the drugs in our communities. That's not me. I ain't make that up. The CIA put the crack in the neighborhoods. Put it right in our neighborhoods. We got to wake up and understand that this Bible is real. This Bible is absolutely real. And I'm going to get to the kicker part right here. Keep reading.
And think to change the time.
So I can read it from the top so you can get the whole gist. I'm breaking it down piece by piece because this is how it's supposed to be broken down. Your pastor will read through these scriptures. He'll read one scripture and then he'll do a whole 3-hour sermon on something way different.
Right.
He'll read a scripture about God says to honor your mother and father. And that's why you gotta pay your tithes. Because your mama will want you to. Your father will want you to. Pay your tithes, folks. The pastor will read one scripture and he gonna go all the way off about whatever he wanna talk about. And it's usually about giving him more money. It's usually about making sure he got more money so he can go buy his wife that whore he land with a Lamborghini truck. Or he can go and get the best cocaine. You know these pastors get high as hell, man. You
right.
know that?
Right.
These pastors get high on the best drugs. They got the money too. You're funding it. You funding that pastor's addiction.
Right.
And you don't even know. You thinking you going to serve God and you serving the cocaine to the pastor. Indirectly. These pastors are liars and they using black people, man. They're finessing black people. They're serving the white man and they're getting us to do the same thing. The Bible says we should follow this. And I'm going to show you why you should follow this, because nobody else predicted the white man changing the time. Nobody else knew Julius Caesar was going to come and add 2 extra months and 90 extra days. Read.
Daniel chapter 7 verse 25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High. And shall wear out the saints of the Most High. And think to change the time.
And think to change what?
Times.
The what?
Times and laws.
The white man is so bold and exalts himself as God so much that he thinks to change the times and the law. Imagine how crazy that is. We know the one thing that you think we can't affect is time, right? Like no matter what, we know we all gonna age in here. It's time. No matter how much you want to fight it, they got all type of creams to stop white women from aging so fast because they age horribly. You understand? But guess what? We know you can't stop time. The white man is so wicked. He said, I may not be able to stop it, but surely I can manipulate it. You understand? Right, hold my beer. I can't stop time. No sweat. Hold my beer. January, February. 2 months for you. That's what the white man does, man. He does what he wants. And not only does he change the time, he changes the laws.
If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.